manifesting is not just a practice to make your dreams reality. It is also the start of your inner awakening. Hi, Bright Light. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Brie and I am a Law of Attraction Mindset Coach. On this channel, you will find everything on Law of Attraction, manifesting, energy work, and self-development. And I appreciate you so much tuning in today and being here with me because it shows your intuitive drive and your curiosity to tap into your internal magic, which are two things to always celebrate. So give yourself a nice little hug of appreciation. And before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on your notification bell so every single week when I upload a new video, you will be the first to know. And if you feel called to, after this video, share it with a loved one or anyone else that you know is interested in Law of Attraction and manifesting. That way, you grow, they grow, and as a collective, we thrive. So out of curiosity, in the comments below, let me know, what do you know about manifesting? There's so much information that you can find on social media, on the internet, that talks about manifesting and how exactly to practice it. We know that we need to pick our desire. We need to think about what it is that we want. Then we need to be able to visualize it, visualize as much details as we can in relation to that desire. Also tying our emotion to that desire, feeling that excitement and that happiness and that abundance as you visualize it being yours. And then we need to be able to let it go and let the universe do its job. So those are pretty much the steps that you follow, but everybody has a different experience, some being positive where their manifestation fully blossoms right in front of their eyes, or a little bit more challenging ones where you just give up and you say it doesn't work. And if you're someone who has tried manifesting, but you feel like it just didn't work out as you wanted it to, well, it's because there's so many layers to manifesting that we don't really know about. And so many false illusions on social media and on the internet of how manifesting should look like. So today we're gonna talk about exactly that, the layers that are a part of manifesting and why you should manifest. So let's think about manifesting as a ball. The core layer is your desire, the thing that you are calling into existence. Then we have outside layers around this desire that include our environment, our surroundings, our loved ones, our mindset. And as we think about our mindset, that includes our mindset blocks, what pretty much holds us back from manifesting. And these outside layers can influence our desire. But when we're just starting to manifest, we don't think about these outside layers that influence us. We're just so focused on our desire. And even when it starts to become challenging and we face these blocks, these layers, the first thing that comes to mind is not to observe them or look further into them. Our ego steps in saying, don't worry about that. You don't need to look at those emotions or these beliefs. And also starts feeding into the doubt that you're already experiencing, making you feel stuck while you're manifesting and making you believe that it is not possible for you. But I'm here to tell you that that is not true. Manifesting is possible for you, but it's important to keep these layers in mind. And now let's jump into the reasons why you should even manifest. So reason number one, as you are manifesting, you know that after you visualized it, after you felt the emotions tied to it, you then have to let it go. And that ability to let go of your desire is what allows you to ultimately surrender to it and also be more patient, establish, activate more of your self-trust so you're able to feel more at ease about the unknown, about the future, and also with life's unexpected events, you feel more in control and able to manage it rather than getting impulsive, getting angry, and reacting from a low vibrational state or from your ego. So in other words, manifesting pretty much helps you to surrender to future unexpected life events and manage them in a different way because of reason number two. So the next reason why you should manifest, and manifesting is not only to create your desires, is because that as you are manifesting, and the outer layers that I mentioned before start influencing your mindset around your desire, you start to look within and you ultimately begin to recreate a relationship with your body, mind, and soul. Because you understand that to manifest successfully, you always want to be in a high state of vibration. So as you begin to notice when you're in a lower state, when you're feeling upset, when you're feeling anxious, when you're feeling doubtful, all those heavy emotions that are considered low vibrational emotions, as you experience them, you begin to consciously take a step back to notice these sensations and to listen to the messages that your body and mind and soul are trying to tell you. Reason number three why you should manifest is because as you begin to observe the sensations that you are feeling and as you take that step back, you're going to also see that suppressed emotions and limiting beliefs that maybe you haven't dealt with from past prior negative hardships or experiences that have influenced this belief and emotion start coming up. So pretty much your suppressed emotions start rising up to the surface as you begin to create and hold the space. And acknowledging these suppressed emotions and beliefs is what's going to lead you to start doing the inner work, whether it be journaling about them, whether it be meditating for more clarity and to ground yourself, whether it be yoga, whether it be breathwork. There's so many inner work practices that you can use to guide you befriending these emotions and beliefs. Ultimately, creating more harmony and balance into your life, which is going to allow you to vibe high. Also want to mention that even on the days where you are having a bad day, something happened, you know, life is so unexpected that our mood is always going to shift and we'll sometimes find ourselves in those low vibrational states, feeling angry, feeling frustrated, whatever the case may be. But if you are feeling these emotions while you are manifesting, just know that it's okay to feel them. What's important is that you acknowledge them, you honor them, and you just take care of yourself and listen to the message that it has to give you rather than ignoring it, creating that resistance, which is going to interfere with your manifestation. So when manifesting, it's okay to feel these emotions. What matters is how you handle the emotion and the situation that is creating this low vibe. And lastly, reason number four why you should manifest is because as you begin to acknowledge the sensations, look within, acknowledge your suppressed emotions, and ultimately befriend them, you begin to create safety in your body to manifest. What creating safety in your body really means is that you begin to feel more at peace, more confident, more abundant, more gratitude by doing the inner work, that you just feel so at ease and ready to receive your desire. So I hope these four reasons allowed you to see why manifesting is not only to make your dreams reality, it's so much more than that. And it ultimately takes your spiritual journey on a whole other level and allows you to tap in and fully embrace your internal magic. And if you're a bold dreamer who is already fantasizing of wanting more for yourself and understands the divine power that you possess, click the link below to learn more about my 3-part Law of Attraction and Manifesting Masterclass, where we talk about quantum physics, mindset blocks, and manifesting techniques. It is such an epic and transformational experience that I can't wait to see you there. And until the next video, live abundantly with love and gratitude.
Let's spread the knowledge learned today and share this video.